Insurance with Jordan Schwartz, partner of Strategic Wealth Designers. Thanks so much for being with us today.
Good to see you.
Most people recognize they need to have life insurance, but how do you know exactly what's right for you?
Mm-hmm. Well, I'll tell you what's not right for you, right? I think sometimes in the insurance world, there's a stigma that life insurance isn't the best thing because of how a lot of people sell life insurance.
Right.
But life insurance is one of the treasures of the investment world. So think about this as a perfect example. Let's say there's a family and they've got two small kids, and let's say that they both work. And I don't know, the spouse, the wife is the primary breadwinner. Well, if something happens to her and there's not life insurance, that could be devastating for a family.
Absolutely.
So life insurance is so unbelievably important. I really think everybody, almost everybody, should have some.
Maybe the kind of thing people don't want to think about because they don't think about that eventuality, but it's something you have to prepare for. There are several different kinds, obviously, of life insurance, but the two widely most known offerings, term and permanent life insurance. What are some of the advantages and disadvantages of both?
Well, term insurance is for a term period of time, so it usually goes for most people to age 70. So the advantage to that is that it's less expensive, but say you go to age 70 and you want insurance, well, now you're going to pay for insurance at that higher age now.
Sure.
So if you have permanent life insurance, it's for your entire life. Right. And being for your entire life, it's going to be a little bit more expensive, but the benefit is that it's for your entire life. So I personally, if structured properly, I like permanent life insurance
better. Plan
better.
Mm-hmm. We certainly know, obviously, health plays a big role in the cost of life insurance. What other factors could play into how much your policy will cost?
Well, age is a big one, right? If you're younger, it's less expensive. If you're older, it's more expensive. Your hobbies and your activities, maybe like the scuba dive or parasail or dangerously
jump out of planes.
Jump out of planes, swim with sharks. If those are your hobbies.
They are not mine.
Okay, but not mine either. I'm pretty boring. That's one. Another one could be weight. Maybe you eat too many ice cream cones. My wife and I live in Fishers.
I do eat too many ice cream cones.
My wife and I went to Fishers at Handel's Ice Cream last night. Took our dog.
So good.
He got a pup cup.
Yeah,
I got a little bit of a bigger cup. So maybe you eat too much ice cream and you're
actually
a little
on the form
more.
You have to fill out how many ice cream cones.
How many ice cream cones? That's like the third question besides age, name, how many ice cream cones do you eat? So that's just a big variable.
But generally your health.
Yeah, generally your health. That's a huge one.
Whether you smoke as well.
Yeah, whether you smoke, gender's another one as well too. Women live longer than guys do. So there's some different variables like that.
All right, Jordan Schwartz, Strategic Wealth Designers. Thank you so much for being with us today. We appreciate it.
Good to see you.
Thanks, gentlemen. Well, we're getting reactions tonight.